Right, so here is going back with my classic Kiki Jiki. We've now got Hex Drinker over called like Giant Killer. Giant Killer has been pretty mediocre. It's just a lot of mana. Hex Drinker like makes it so there's a lot of matchups where you just play like Hex Drinker when your opponent taps out and level it to 3, and then you just win the game instantly. So I think that seems like a much more reasonable tutor target for Ranger Captain than the Giant Killer, where Giant Killer was always just a card to pitch to Solitude, which is fine, but it sucked to draw that card. It was horrible. And in the sideboard, I've got my Kotaki back. A lot of Rhino hate. Oh, I should probably play. No, this is fine, right? We've got our Ardraneth and everything, so this is fine. Yeah. I do not like these Birds of Paradises, though. So, yeah, I think we'll rock and roll like this. Or 8, 17. Yeah, we've got a lot. We've got plenty of white cards. We are kind of low on white cards compared to other versions of the deck I've played in my lifetime, but should be fine. I kind of want to. We might want to play more cycle lands though with four Ren and Sixes in the future, but I kind of like how clean the mana base is right now. So. This art is pretty good, it's just the white border is whack. I'm gonna go get a Temple Garden so that we have double white up for Ranger Captain if our bird gets got. Ren and Stimpy. I think I'm still gonna just Ranger Captain. Just be more mana efficient. And I think if this is a Murktide plays Flooded Strand, so I'll probably get the Hex Drinker here. Murktide can play Flooded Strand, and so also have Ren and Six Bisseju if it's something weird. I could try. I'll probably blue white control. In which case, Hex Drinker is a lot worse against that, because they have like Solitude and Verdicts and like Planeswalkers. And Prismatic Ending. Yeah, there's a lot. Hex Drinker's, it's fine, right? Like, but we'll attack first. Play a wall. Do I want to sack this and then get my Ren and Six down? I think so. I don't want to be missing my land drops. I think a Ranger Captain to play is fine as well, though, because it means I'm pressuring my opponent, but Renin 6 is very similar to that. I'll play the Hex Drinker, and I probably level it up 3 times if I can. And then hold up Ephemerate for, like, my wall. I don't know what this is. I'm so confused. He is not solituding my wall of omens. Oh no. Don't do it, opponent. Don't do it. Okay. That means he likely doesn't have verdict, though. It's kind of weird that he used the counterspell on the Hexdrinker if he had Solitude in his hand, though. Like, I think that was just a mistake. Like, he should have let me sink my mana into it. I don't know if my opponent's played Magic before. Magic Online. Yeah, I stand by that statement. Ooh, we can E-whip back Ranger Captain. That seems good. This is going to be a long one. I can feel it. Opponent's used almost 6 minutes already. It's turn five. Yep, I don't know if he's a Magic Online veteran or not. Just dash and... Tegan Vale Summers generally. Cards like Archon of Amiri are pretty awkward. Same with Maggot. Yeah, just take out a bunch of one offs. Seems fine. I don't think we want more Besaiju's or. We'd go like down a forest for Besaiju. Have like a chalice answer. Dude, I really want to play this deck. This deck is... Dude, I freaking hate it when Spike has a deck that he built that's so, like, similar to something I have. But I had this, like, Nahiri Fury Solitude Ephemerate deck back a while ago. And Blood Sun, and then he's, like, doing a Blood Sun Golos type thing. With it, which seems good, because you get to a, like, you have a lot of just five drops in your deck anyway from Fury and Solitude, and that's a deck I really want to play. What if I just play every single one of Aspiring Spiked decks? That'll be my thing. We'll just go turn one Ragavan here. Our mana is a little bit awkward. We're going to be playing this as a forest, so I think we want a red-white. So that we'll be able to set up for a Ranger Captain. This will be our only red. So, I mean, I hope that the Ragavan just connects, right? Then we'll be able to Ren and six with Veil backup, but... Oh, we'll be able to resolve Ren anyway if he uses a removal spell on the Rag, so I think we're chilling. Okay, we're fine. just resolves. Interesting. I think I'll play the bird. Sure. I feel like Archmage's Charm steals my Ragavan, and that's like whatever, right? That's his prerogative. I'd get to just like ping the rag, and then it's like a just a pretty bad trade for him. You click it. You've already done it correctly so many times. Concede. He's gonna concede. Oh, he's not. Wow. He's got mental fortitude. More mental fortitude than me. I've gotten pretty flooded, but it's all right. We'll run out of lands in our deck eventually, right? Yeah. All right, well, I don't know how much I can count that one, but get to go first again. No. Mulligan. We can't cast any spells in our hand. This is better. Ditch a cord. Some shadow action. Interesting. Oh, Living End. Just kidding. I forgot that they play Street Wraith, honestly. I'm gonna miss that call. I'm gonna really miss that call. No, we're gonna be one off of playing that. Damn. What the hell is going on? Wait, what did he pitch? Oh, he pitched another force. Look, he has the land. Why would he ever do this? Brazen Borrower. This was a bold keep. I guess this hand would have been good against some a more linear deck, right? Like Double Force and Grief. Brazen Borrower, yeah. It's a fine keep. Playing a curator, okay. Might die to just a bunch of big dumb idiots. Kind of want to find a solitude. It's our main goal. Pretty good here. Sunken Ruins is broken. It's gonna kill my Wren. I want a bunch of dumb 4/4s. No! Oh, I should have attacked because I'm going to ephemerate it anyway. That was a punt. Should I even ephemerate it right now? Yeah, I should. I get Hex Drinker and then I. I've never played with a level up card online before. Weird. We're racing, buddy. Five drop does he have? I can go get any four drop. I could get. I'm pretty sure we're just leveling up our Hex Drinker, right? I get like Maggot of the Moon. I get Archon. We get Yuwit. Getting Yuwit makes it. No, let's just level up our Hex Drinker, actually. Then we can. Just chump here. We don't even have to chump yet, so it's whatever. I don't think we can. Oh, well, if he top decks another Living End, maybe that's just a spew, actually. I'm a moron. Yeah, because he could just wake her into a fucking thing. I'm so stupid. I should have just gone and got in there. I just kind of forgot. I used all my shit. I guess I get some stuff back, and he's at three. But Waker is huge because it's a big flyer. So that was kind of crazy that he got hit that. You did not. I'm such stupid. I'm so stupid. Dude, but that's his best possible sequence. Wake her into this shit. Like, fuck off, dude. Seriously. Fuck off. Like, he literally. Cannot believe I played that so poorly. That's so frustrating. That's so stupid. And I drew a fucking land. I cannot believe I did that. Jesus Christ. I guess I deserve to lose. I don't know. I don't know. That was fucking stupid. I shouldn't be that much of a moron. Like I was going to do it. I could have just got Maggot and then I could never lose. I don't know what's wrong with me. No, not Maggot. Yeah, Maggot would I would still be cold to Violent Outburst. So no, not Violent Outburst. No, nothing. I literally should have just got maggots. I'm so stupid. Shit is usually way too slow. Is this hand even keepable? Probably not. I don't care. No, don't pass through the whole turn. Don't pass through the whole turn. Ugh. I'm going to play the Ranger Captain first, just because it's a little more mana efficient. And it attacks for more damage. My opponent is discarding to hand size, apparently. Fuck you, dude. Grief. I'm bluffing a Veil of Summer. I think I'd rather exile the grief, right? If I just Jesus Christ. Every turn that goes by, it gets way worse for me. And he peeled a fucking his thing already, so now we really need to draw something, right? Can't fail that. Now we want him to, because we can call for endurance. That we got anything that we could play. I should have pitched the Renin 6 over the cord. I'm still on no land. We're gonna lose to just a bunch of hard cast fucking big boys. No. Most likely. Our land. We just need to draw one Wall of Omens and we get to completely blank this clock as well. Or we can just draw a bunch of fucking ephemerates as well, I guess. And and then lose the game. So we could draw Solitude, we could draw... Wall of Omens, we could have drawn Elodomri's Call. We could draw literally anything. Now I just get to stack my deck. No, we'll actually Veil. There we go, that's a spell at least. There we go. Okay. Thank you. Alright, we had some misplays there. I played that game to those matches pretty bad, but I think our deck is just so good against Living End overall that it didn't matter. So. I'm going first. This is a game I'll keep, hand I'll keep on the play. Don't you dare run and six me. Okay. Okay, 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 okay. Okay, we're not... We haven't lost. I don't know what's going on. I'm a little scared of what's going on, so. Yeah. Huh. What the fuck? Wait, if I dash, then I can't play anything. Holy shit. This Archon sucks for me. Oh, Archon's really good against Dwarven Mine. Right? Dude, yeah. Wait, that's pretty good. Okay, okay, okay. We're chilling. Because then he can't even. It looks like he's Prismatic Ending. Oh, or Teferi, I guess. Okay. Hold up Ephemerate here. We'd save my Archon from a removal spell. Opponent is in the tank. Oh, we can't. They have a Teferi in play. We can't save our Archon. I fucking love Teferi, dude. I love Teferi. Look at this. He's gonna get it. Oh, he didn't fall for it. What the hell is this? Prime time. You like a. Does he have prime time? What the fuck? How is that allowed at all? Awesome. That was fucking awesome, I guess. That was so stupid. Okay. Well, we can't really beat this deck. This deck is kind of horseshit. So it's whatever. I don't care. Yeah. What do you even do? Breed like Charma? Good job, dude. You cast your prime time. Good job. You play a deck that's good against creature decks. Well played. Well played, dude. Good job. I hope you never play against, never play against a linear combo deck. That'll never happen to you. Don't worry about it, buddy. Don't worry about it. Just pretend it doesn't exist. I fucking love that Valakut works like that as well, by the way. That you get to, like, quadruple trigger it off of, like... I love that Teferi can answer any creature in the entire game. I love Teferi. I love that, I don't know. Just fuck this guy's deck, basically. Teferi. This game will be really fun if he plays Teferi next turn. Aww. Poor little baby. Okay. I don't want to play against this guy. This is gonna be a lot of fun. Oh, he gets to just do it on my turn. Just kidding. Oh, fuck that deck. That deck is just, like, I don't know. It's so mind-numbing to me. Decks like that, just... I hate them. It's like, where is it? What even is that deck called? Prime Time, Primeval Titan, Activity. Yeah, this shit. It's just such horse shit, dude. Like, oh, you're gonna have a good. This guy played remands that I played against. Like, I don't know. You're just gonna get fucked by like that food deck would fuck this deck over. You couldn't do shit against like. There's so much shit that it's like, I don't like decks that you play where you're like, I'm playing this deck that's really good matchups against this deck, and then that's all I'm doing is I'm flipping a coin every game to see what deck I'm gonna play against. It's just stupid. Like I'm not like, why would you even have, how would you even have fun doing that, dude? Because you could just like, oh look, I played against a creature deck that doesn't have a lot of good tools to interact with me just getting to a bunch of fucking Valakut land. Like, oh, I guess I win. Oh, look, I played against Neoform. Oh, I lose because I played against Neoform. Oh, there's nothing I can do. Oh, well, fuck off. Get rid of, like, a... Hex Drinker, I suppose. No, we'll get rid of a bird. It rots my brain playing against those things. It's so frustrating. Use your Searing Blaze on something else. Are you ready to counter some rift bolts? Alright, my opponent needs 3 actual factual lightning bolts here. Three actual lightning bolts. Or lava spikes. So 3/1 mana. Nice. It's mostly these two against burn. I guess it's probably better than something in here, right? Running 6 kind of sucks against this deck. Kiki Jiki's almost honestly probably better. I'm gonna mulligan. I will be forced to keep. This hand sucks though. Don't get tricked. I was trying to find a hand that could do anything before, like, yeah, like this would have just killed us with any of those other hands. So it's whatever. It's also awesome that these were two, I guess I should have just ditched the Sacred Foundry, right? But dude, I haven't got. I haven't hit a single land off of these. If my opponent's hand is all lands. You know what, yeah, fuck Renin 6. Go to 5. Mulligan, mulligan, mulligan. Do I want to go get Forge Tender? I think I'll probably save this for like a Night of Autumn, right? Oh, I should have played my Wooded Foothills or my Stomping Ground actually tapped. Yeah. Yeah, I should have played the Stomping Ground for sure. I should have also got a freaking white source. I don't know why I'm playing the horribly. Jesus. Gain three here. Okay, that's the same as me gaining three. Turn out Concord for one. Get. I'll probably just call though for Knight. Yeah. Let's call for Knight. Or we can call for Solitude. I'm just getting Knight of Autumn, yeah. Dude, Wall of Omens is so good. I love Wall of Omens. can bolt this, but then it's like we're gaining 3. Now my opponent's getting pretty low. I don't think I have any other way to gain life in my deck besides Solitude. We'll just pass. Still at a healthy 11, dude. Kiki! Kiki, father! My dad, Kiki Jiki, bringing home another victory. Let's go, Kiki Jiki. Alright, we've only lost to one bullshit deck that doesn't even count as magic, so I'm liking it so far. I do want to make room for a lone missionary in here, but this list is, like, tight. It's very tight right now. Like, all these cards have such important applications. So, I don't know. The only card that's pretty arbitrary is, like, the chords. But you can go up or down chords, I think. But And honestly, I'm pretty low on chord right now, so... But then, like, when you take chords out of your deck, then you're losing equity on all those one-ofs, so then it makes it a lot less good. Like, it's just weird. It's like, can I really cut a quarter calling for a one-of? Like...
That's how it works.
Ken's good against a lot of decks. Turn one, Hollowed Fountain tapped. Makes me worried about these Solitudes. My two lands. Okay, hammer. I'll probably slam a Magus against hammer. And I'll probably just Solitude this Cauldra or this Stoneforge. See what I draw. I think I might rather just play the Archon, right? Yeah. Let's play the Archon this turn. It makes it hard to do any. It makes it hard for him to do anything with the hammers anyway. And slows him down a lot. Like, Magus probably slows him down too, but the only thing Magus kind of keeps him off is Pierce Steel. Which is obviously going to play fucking Pierce Steel here, I guess. Oh, I'm a fucking idiot. No, because... Okay, I play this game. Oh, no, because that turns it into a mountain. Nah, duh, duh. That was my intention. I stunlock myself so easily with random, like, things. I would just hope we draw, like, a white source here. Play the bird. If he plays another equipment here, I might solitude the pure steel. Yeah. It's pretty unlucky. I should have done it in the other order, I think. I should have played the maggot first. That's a good draw. Another planes is good for him. Fuck, is he on another pure steel? Yeah, we'll have to solitude that. But he probably would have played another pure steel if he had it, so. Are you serious, man? Are you for real? Okay. That's really unlucky. I don't know what the fuck we do now. That's just his best card. And he gets to move them all back, so we can't even attack on the ground. It's fucking horseshit. We need to draw another solitude. Basesu is pretty good. We have Basesu the Ornithopter. Kind of like Basesuing the Ornithopter here, right? No, because then if he draws a land, he gets to Cauldra and then kill us. So I think we just play the Wren. Attack him for two. Then we'll besiege you, like one of the hammers here. Well, we'll probably besiege the Ornithopter in combat, right? And then we'll plus, and then we'll buy back the besiege you. It just kind of sucks that we can't do it on our main phase, because we miss out on like a double besiege you next turn. But hopefully, we just draw something better than that. You know what? Or I could go for a hammer. Just get both hammers. No, I like just killing the Ornithopter. Hopefully he just has a bunch of Urza Sagas in his hands. Oh, he had another fucking Ornithopter, so we made the wrong choice, I guess, right? All right. Call is a good draw. If he just attacks here, we'll just block call. Oh, we needed to call on our turn. We can just call and also besiege you, I guess. That was a spew. I think I'm just gonna besiege you one of the hammers and then take 12. Dude, he has more planes? You play four planes in that deck? Playing Memnite over Cauldra. Interesting. gonna go for this here. I know he has at least. Whew. All right, that was a game. That was indeed a game of magic. Oof. That, this. Revoker's okay. Abyssage's really good. Magus is really good. Combo's okay. Endurance is pretty bad. Ranger Captain is pretty mediocre. Archon's usually kind of weird. Ragavan sucks. Hex Drinker, I'm going to say sucks. We can't use it that much mana for that. We could trim another Ranger Captain. I like our combo a lot in this matchup. Rock and roll like this. I don't think we want Charmaz. And I don't really like Revoker. Revoker's okay, but it's kind of like a shitty collector oof, right? The more I think about Revoker, the less I like having it in the sideboard, because I really just want it for artifact cards, and I would always just rather have a collector oof. So, you know. He's A and awesome. No zero mana creature? Nice. No zero mana creature is huge. Next turn we can call for solitude and double solitude. Solitude ephemerate, so just kinda have to make it through this turn. Pure steel, huh? This makes sense, because now he gets to draw a card with his hammer. Nope, never mind. He wants to hold up Mana Leak, maybe? I want to hold up second call over Noble. Over playing the Noble this turn. I think he likely had a counter, so he was waiting until he could hold up. Alright, he has one hammer, two hammers in his hand now. I think I'm just going to go for... Oh, hammer reality chip. Okay. You should hammer in response, get the card draw. But I'll ephemerate in response so he can't. And then we'll call for Knight or Magus, probably. We'll just call for Magus. Shut him off of blue. And then kill this Urza Saga and every other Urza Saga. So we'll be fine. I think we got this locked up. So now he's on hammer and an unknown card. Oh, fuck, Hushbringer. Fuck this card. We need to find another Renin 6 to ping it again. No, because he has a hammer. Jesus Christ. Dude, and it is lifelink. Are we just cold to that? I think we're cold to this. That's such shit. Fuck Hushbringer. What can we bring in that beats that? Hex Drinker? That's always been my dilemma, but I've never thought that it's been worth it to sideboard for Hushbringer, because Hushbringer is only good against this deck specifically. It's pretty shit against 4-color, like 4-color Yorion, because they just play so many like single target removal spells that you're just playing a 2-mana 1/2 that you just trade one for one, and that's not what you want to be doing against them. So, yeah, that's why. But I don't know what else we can do here. We're kind of fucked. Yeah, I guess we just want one of those. I guess we could have found Baseju's eventually and killed, but they're just going to be gaining so much life. Like, we'll never kill a Hushbringer. They'll eventually, like, I don't know. just stupid. I love cards that are just so disgustingly efficient against certain decks that you just can't beat them. It's awesome. Awesome. Let's draw Ephemerate or a land. Or a fucking Kiki Jiki, I guess. Okay. We lose, I guess. It's okay. I did only keep a 3-land hand. I should have seen this coming. Yeah, I only kept a 3-land hand. Well, I'm such a fucking retard. I'm so stupid. Why am I so fucking stupid? Jesus. I wish I was better at magic. Fuck. You're not making a token? Oh, that's how it works. I could also have gotten Oof, but he would have played a Pierce Steel last, like, a while ago if he had it, so. Wish that you could not click on that. Good job, Kentucky. Eat those bad boys up. Interesting. He really has the Pierce Steel? Crazy. I'll just solitude this in response to like a hammer, I guess. He has a Caldera. I guess I should have responded and killed this. Oh, I have to anyway, because you get to move the fucking hammer. Fuck me. I'm a fucking idiot. Okay. Dude, this deck is so whatever. It's fine. I'm playing not good against it, but yeah, I should have really responded to the Pierce that activation. I am pretty. He does not have blacksmith's fuckery!